Hello everyone, Another Clouds here, and today guys we're gonna finish our reviews on the Slicer, because in fact there were 12 set releases between 1999 and the year 2000, but just on 6 of them, so of course I'm gonna review the two last I own, if I can say so, and that will be all for my Slicer review before I get some new Slicers off the internet, I think, of eBay or Bricklink or stuff like that. So today we're gonna review two guys, and they're gonna be from the bad guys, because yeah, you might know that the Slicer was also known as Trobots in the US, and the storyline differs from one region to another one. And so these two guys were in fact in the there were two of the four bad guys released, if I can say so. And I do not own the Canister Nether and the instrument booklet for this one, because I bought him off Bricklink, so I'm gonna begin right now with the set itself. It's called Jungle or Amazon in US, and here we go. Of course I have to put this disc on. So you can see that the color scheme is green, normal green, and also some teal green. I think that's alright, so teal green, like for example the City Slicer. And yes, here we go. So in fact this one is not really that different from the other, because it's really simple. For example, I'm gonna take the ice slicer to show you the comparison. So here we go. Notice the parts used and stuff like that, how they are used. And now we're gonna see how is made the jungle slicer. So yeah, first of all, it's used of course the same body frame, but also the same big gears on this one. So the big gears it just used for on ice, fire, and on this one also the same head, but with a different visor. So notice the visor, of course it's a printed part, it's not a stickers, it's a printed part, and this one is more like with a robotic and a beast feeling. Notice the little tiger design right here. So that's all for the body part. We can also notice that the shoulders are put in this way, so in the front way and not like that. Just the difference from ice is the fact that the throwing disc arm is put on the right side and not on the left side. On the left side you have the normal arm, if I can say so, which this time holds a katana right here, which is of course the same part used for the Lego minifig in black. Kind of cool, even if it's kind of a little katana in comparison to the size of the slicer, but still it's well, it's okay. The thing that differs is this gears on the back, which is bigger than the little one used on the good guys, for example, and I think it's easier to turn the this part this way with a bigger gear right there, at least for me and my fingers. Right now we're gonna talk about the legs, which are quite the same in fact, apart from the connector which are put this way, which is different from this one, and in fact made the pelvis wider, as you can clearly see, and the legs are quite the same, with this time of course no ski, but the traditional slicer feet. So the parts I call the A part, because it looks like your A, at least for me. And then finally I think the only little details for this slicer is the antenna right here on his back, which is really simple in fact, because it just put to this connector right here, so with an axle of 2 we're gonna put this part here, and then finally the antenna, which is used again in the Lego system set. And here we go, we have the slicer, the jungle slicers complete. Just gonna add his disc. So yes, his disc is green, and of course it's the one with two light on, so of course it represents the element of the slicers plus the background where he lives, so the jungle of course. And here we go, I think we are done for this one. So in fact it's quite simple because it's not that different from the ice slicer, but the four bad guys are really really different than the other guys. So in fact between the bad guys it is completely different, because we're gonna see that with the energy slicer which coming next, that they are in fact really all different. So yeah, I think we're done with the jungle slicers, and now I'm gonna talk about energy, also known as Electron. And this time I have both the canisters and the instruction booklet. So here's the canister or the case. It's quite the same, of course, but this time the colors are the colors used are black and purple, which is quite cool because purple is not really unusual color. Oh, it's full of dust, seriously. I should have opened this one before reviewing, but well. So yeah, in the same at the inside you have okay, you have some space right here to put your disc, and here of course you put the slicer where you transform in kind of way. You just change the disposition of the part and then you put it in the canisters. And here we go. So it's the same apart from the color, which change. You can still put your name right here, and that's all. And now for the instruction booklet. So here we go with the nice instruction with, of course, the natural enemy of the slicer. So kind of a evil tornado, I don't really know. You can also notice some other slicers on the background, but it really look like the same as energy slicer. So maybe there is not the only one. So yes, instruction, nothing really new. Show you how to use the throwing arm and to launch the disc in the canister. Well, I think we're gonna store him later, but I'm gonna review him first. And then of course, you put this, okay, the instruction booklet upside down, and then you can build your instruction for the command well, which is this one, and it's called the Ultra Wax. Yeah. So the Ultra Wax, and let just me find the, yeah, the page with the little poster right here. So of course it really look like a dinosaur this time. And here you can clearly see that there are the four bad guys, and the Genius Slicers is really different from the other one. I'm not gonna say much for now, but notice the Rock Slicer, for example, the Electro Slicer, the Energy, and then the, I think it's the Judge. They are really different from the Jungle one. But we're gonna see that right now. Oh, and yeah, also, notice that his visor right here is in a clear smoke color, so transparent smoke color. And I do not have this one, I've lost the part somewhere, so excuse me for this. But I will show you the slicer without his visor. I think, I know it's kind of suck, but I lost the part, so excuse me for that. But you can see, yeah, he still is really have a visor and it's in a clear smoke color. But I do not have this on my set because I've lost it. So here we go, and as you can see, it's really, it's again completely different this time. It's really, it really doesn't look like the same as Jungle. And also, it's completely different from the other one I've shown you earlier, even the City Slicer, which was on wheel. So this time, this guy also is not a biped, he's not on two legs, but he's on four legs. So kind of like a bug, in fact, I can say so, or a fly, because of the little wings. So how it works, in fact, really easy, because as you can see, this time we are not gonna use the same body frame as the other slicer. So, well, it's really, really easy to show. So we're gonna use, excuse me, some dust on here. We're gonna use this part, which is in fact two parts, which were also used on the. So you have these two parts. We're gonna link them together. Right here. Then we're gonna put the head on this kind of hard to explain what it is, but you can see you have a ball joint, kind of axle, and then you have some gear parts, if I can say so, all the way of the parts. Right here, we're gonna of course put the connectors and then the head, which is black this time, of course. And ah yes, of course, yeah, the color scheme is purple and black. Excuse me for that. Oh, and also I noticed that I have, yes, as you can see, I do not own, in fact, two of this part. I've also lost one of the purple gears, so I have to replace with a gray one. So excuse me also for this little problem of parts. So as you can see, you can fold it, but of course it falls down. So next step, you're gonna put this like that, and then add the two little wings, which are in fact just some axle of three with gears, and the slicer lift arm. It's called this way. But I call this slicer panel personally. So we're gonna put this like that. Yeah, it works. So as you can see also, you have the gears right here, and of course we're gonna link these gears to this one. And so This means that when I will push the head like that, it will open. Well, maybe I have just wait. I'm gonna change the stuff because I think I have done something wrong. In fact, yes, you're supposed first to do that. So when, oh no, no, okay, I was right. So excuse me for that. I think I thought I done something wrong, but no, no, I was okay on this. Right, I'm gonna do that. So excuse me again. And yeah, of course, when I push this down, it opens the wings. So it's replaced, in fact, the gear system which was used on the slicer. Oh, and I didn't show you the articulation for the jungle slicer, excuse me, a jungle robot, not jungle slicer, an Amazon robot. So I will show this you later. I will show this to you later. And then we're gonna end this right now because I think I'm too long. So I'm just gonna check the instruction booklet to not make anything wrong. So you have the two legs right here, so they are really simple. It's just two connectors put together with this little axle. We're gonna put this axle all right there. Well, yes, it works like that. The same goes for this one. And finally, we're gonna add the throwing disc arm, right there on the shoulder, on a slicer shoulder, like this. Like that. And here we go. I just have to put the disc, which this time is in purple color. So again, we have the elemental disc of this one, so with the kind of the lightning right here. The lightning bolt in the middle, really nice also. And yeah, the articulation on this one, so of course it got one part of articulation per leg, if I can say so. So it's not really, you can't really move him in tons of ways, in fact. Maybe you can try some stuff, but well, it's kind of limited, of course. Yeah, you can still do some stuff like that, which look cool. Like this. Of course, we got one part of articulation on this right on this one, but it's not really that useful, if you ask me. Just to put the throwing disc like that, and oh yeah, like that. I prefer this. And yeah, that's quite all. And of course, you have the gear, so when you push down the head, it flaps the wings in kind of way, so you can make them closed or open. And it's really nice because it's compact and it's worked pretty well. So here we go for the energy one. I think I'm gonna just put him into his canisters and show you the application of the Amazon robot. And then we will be done with this review, I think. So on this one, you're supposed to turn the head like that, then put the two front legs here. Okay, this one, the rear legs are put on this way, and then that's quite all. You just have to put this in. It doesn't really work that well, but oh yes, no, I think it's okay. You're supposed to put that in this way, and here we go. It's done. Excuse me. And finally, yes, so it's gonna really be quick. The jungle slicer, so of course you have two parts of articulation on the legs, right here. So excuse me if I have already talked about articulation, but I don't remember to have talked about this one, so excuse me, seriously. So yes, two parts of articulation on this one, two parts also on this arm. Just one, of course, on the throwing arm disc, but you can still block the movement right there thanks to the shoulder part. The same goes for this leg, this arms, of course. Can block the arms in it. And of course, finally, you've got the gears at the back, which allow you to level up or level down the head and the head, shoulders and arm section, if I can say so, or the upper section in fact. And it really works nice thanks to the bigger gear, I think. It's really easier and quicker than to do this on ice, for example. And that's all, guys. So as you see, in fact, it's really different from the energy is really different from the Jungle One, and also the work slicer, so the tan and dark gray one, I think it's in these colors, is also quite different because it's kind of the same as energy. It's got four legs. And finally, the Judge Slicer, so the fourth one, is also pretty different, even if it's used, in fact, the same frame as this one. It's kind of a crossover between a biped slicer, so like this one, but still used this frame type to have some working wings, I think. And here we go. And I think that's all for this review, yes, so I'm gonna just show you all the slicer I own. So I don't really think they will all enter in the same shot. Like that. So this one was ice, this one was city, and this one was fire. And there. I'm gonna add fire maybe on the side, I think. Okay. And finally, we're gonna add a sub slicer. So the blue one. So also this one, there is missing an hose pipe. And it's kind of hard to place because of their long arms. Yes. So I'm gonna try something. Well, it's not really that good, but still. Well, I think that will... Yeah, like that. And here we go, so... For all the slicers I own, so the six I own, which were released as part of what I call the first wave, and the second wave was just, in fact, four other slicers, but which were kind of so different, in fact. And so that's all. So if you have, if you want me to do a conclusion on this one, to do the setup, I will just say that the slicers are really great because, even if of course the articulation are kind of limited nowadays, and they are really not really as big as for example the last toy Nikkei and stuff like that, they are quite cool because they are really all different, more different in fact than the toy Holda, because even if they use, you can see the same frame, for example. There's five ones use the same frame, but they're really all different, as you can see, just because of little parts which change position or stuff like that. So, for example, as you have seen, the parts for the pelvis part right here with the connectors always change position, so it's really like it's really different every time. So yeah, it's really full of little details which really makes them all unique in their in terms of design and stuff. So. Well, that's really what I like about the slicers throughout the series, and I think that they are really great for that. Also, the functions are not that bad. The throwing disc function only work well, in fact, if you have not used parts like, for example, mine on the ice, but still it works well. And the disc also works pretty nicely done, if you ask me. Okay, it just fell off. So, yeah, I think seriously that it's a great... It's a good team, and if you really can find some of this in Garage Sale or in other place, seriously, just try to buy them if they're not really too high in terms of price, because they're really well worth it, I think. Seriously, they are all different, and they really got a unique design thanks to their throwing arm, their throwing disc arm, and also their head, which are really specific to them with the little visor and stuff like that. It's really look great. So that's all for this review, guys. Hope you enjoy them. And if you have any question on the Trobot or slicer I have not answered in my review, feel free to ask them. And of course, if you want to know more about the story and stuff like that, I recommend you to go on the lego.wikia.com and search for the slicer page, where you will find tons of information on the two different storylines which depend on the region, so Europe or US, and also on each of the characters. And you will also be able to see the six horse slicers I have not been able to show you because I don't own them at this time. And that's all! So, hope you enjoy this one, guys, and see you later for another Bionicle or LEGO reviews. Bye bye!